Good morning, one and all. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome each one of you for Fourth Dimension Media's first e-conclave today. So we're going to be doing about five such e-conclaves covering all the five southern states in India. So our whole objective is to basically evangelize the South Indian markets. And for people who know us and for people who don't know us, we represent Tamil Nadu's number one news channel, Pudhiya Thalaimurai. We have Telangana's number one news channel, which is V6 News. We have the federal.com, PT.com, and we are known to do, the large formats, B2B summits and all that. So before I, I don't want to waste anybody's time. So it gives me pleasure to welcome our panelists and captains of the industry. And thank you, Srikanth from Goldwinner Oil. Then we have Bhavna Mittal from RPSG Group, where it's Media and Marketing Services. Then we have Hariharan Vishwanathan, fondly called as Vishi from Mediacom. Then we have my friend Shubha Srinivasan, who heads Media and Godrej. Then we have Mahesh Anand from Nippon Paints. And then our moderator, we have Shiram from Levista Coffee. So thank you all. And thank you once again for participating. We have, I guess, more than 90 odd people who have tuned in. And over to you, Shiram.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Shankar, for putting across this wonderful, conclave. It feels as much as we're all, sitting next to each other, facing each other, of course, with the support of the audience as well. So first of all, thank you so much to Shankar and for 4DN. And of course, my wonderful panelists, no particular order, Bhavna, Shubha, Vishi, Mahesh, Bharat, and Srikanth. So thank you, everyone. Very good morning to all the attendees and, people who have joined in large numbers for today's seminar. So thank you for everyone to come over here. Tamil Nadu, the state that I belong to, born, brought up here in Madras. I still call it Madras all the time. I cannot fathom the fact that people have renamed it as Chennai. So a lot of stuff happening here. We were number one, we were number two, we are number three now. We've been pushed down, fortunately, in the corona rankings, right? So it's Maharashtra, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu now. The joke in the months of April and May was, look, RCB was not here as well. So, that was a very terrible joke. But unfortunately, now the numbers are swelling. But I think so much of action happening in Chennai and Tamil Nadu as well. So I'm gonna probably request my co-panelists to speak a few words about how the Tamil Nadu market has reacted for your respective businesses, specific to the industry or the categories that each one of us represent. And then I will sum it up in round one, and then we'll go probably two or three rounds. And then, we'll probably go with the flow in terms of the audience questions and interactions and all that. So yes, we started a little bit late, but I think we're still on time. We can always catch up. So would like to start with Shubha, in terms of overall media, Shubha, what's been your observation in the last 6 months, starting from January till now, 2 months before Corona and thereafter, more at an industry level. And of course, since for those who don't know, Shubha is also on the board of BARC, B-A-R-C, India. And she's been with an advisor for a very long time on the BARC board as well. So your observations, Shubha, in terms of how the overall media has taken up, and then we'll go to Bhavna thereafter that. Yes.
Thank you, Shriram. So if you look at the change that you asked me about, you can actually divide it into three different phases, because you spoke about Jan till now, it becomes three different phases. Jan till March, things were going, in a certain direction, which is more normal, the normal that we used to know till last year. March onwards and till the end of June, I would say, has been a different pattern when it comes to viewership. There has been a huge shift in the viewership. There has been an increase in the overall viewership in terms of television viewers in absolute. And this is a phenomenon that's observed across the country. Of course, region-wise and segment-wise, for different audience groups, there are multiple differences, especially when it comes to how we use them for targeting and media planning. And from July, mid-July, we've observed a different pattern, which is more reflective of, the fact that there is new content now which has started across television in the country. Shoots have resumed. There is new content on board. The period which is March to say mid-July is primarily a period where there has been a lot of fluctuation, change in preferences, new genres coming up, people showing different behavior than what they earlier used to. Afternoon emerging as a prime. There is a higher news consumption, higher consumption on movie channels, and it's absolutely reflective of people and their own behavior. As all of us know, that that is primarily the lockdown phase. All of us were inside. A lot of us continue to be inside. Some people have resumed work. Businesses have started opening up and resuming, and that's how I would, you know, summarize the trends at a very broad level.
Interesting. Bhavna, we were talking yesterday, you know, in terms of how, you know, you've been in media for 20 years now, started off from the agency and then, you know, moved on to brands and managing Copcom and so on. So what has been your observation? How do you think the market has been responding in general and specific to Tamil Nadu as well?
So I guess Shubha has kind of touched upon it, saying that TV has seen almost unprecedented viewerships, which we haven't seen in a lot of time. Like, I remember when earlier when we started working, we used to have these high viewership times and high TRP programs. And now suddenly that's kind of come back to us. News genre typically has seen almost 180-190% increase. So especially in TN as well, there has been a very high increase. I think specifically for the TN market, there was some bit of original programming which started a little because there was an ease in the lockdown, but then again it got closed. So the original programming has started from yesterday. And that's when we might see a bit of rise in the GEC channels, because GEC otherwise, which was the highest contributing genre, has actually been pretty much stagnant across most markets and more so in TN. So movies have gone up, news has gone up, kids channels have gone up. So again, we see it all in our own families. We know that, you know, everybody is really sitting and doing it as sitting and watching TV. And again, from an OTT platform also, there have been a rise in the viewership as well. And specifically, let's say in TN, with this new movie, which is released only on the OTT platform, that's also come in. I don't know the name. Sorry, I'm the only non-Tamilian in this group, as we realized. So I'm not even going to make an attempt to say the name. But that's, you know, how... So there is going to be a shift in the preferences of people as well and what they view. And again, from our one of our businesses, Saregama, which is... also produces a lot of programming for TN market. I know Roja is one serial which is doing pretty well. So there also, finally, we have resumed the production. So let's see. Hopefully, things will start normalizing a bit.
Interesting. Coming to Srikanth, you know, one of the most popular household brands of Tamil Nadu, if I would say rest of South India and India, of course, you know, gold winner. I think gold winner in the last 20 years or so has created a category which is, you know, at par with probably, you know, the erstwhile most famous Sundrop, which was a national brand, and later on moved away from the ITC stable. But I think gold winner is very, very household, probably I would say, you know, in South India. I got to know yesterday, very envious of Srikanth, that, you know, gold winner is available at over 100,000 retail touch points in India, 1 lakh outlets, of which about a fourth of them are only in Tamil Nadu market. So I think that's a... So how are you communicating to these people outside of the prime time, the television, Srikanth? And of course, your observation on the overall trends, you know, probably preceded, you know, you can start with that and then probably how Gold Winner is, you know, attacking the opportunity.
Hey, thanks for the nice intro, and you know, a good morning to all of you here. Luckily, what I would say is, touch wood, we have been in the edible oil business, and we are part of the essential, so-called essentials category. So we have actually been largely untouched by this corona epidemic that has affected many businesses all over. In fact, we have got a huge delta in terms of our growth. We have seen growths that are happening in TN that we have not seen for the past several years, you know, thanks to this pandemic in a way. What has happened is that because the restaurants are all shut down and number of eating joints have come down significantly, people are stuck in their homes and the home consumptions have shot through the roof. And the next thing that has also happened is that traditionally palm oil has been considered as something which is, though it is low priced, but so because of this pandemic and the consequences of being very hygienic, people have been staying away from palm oil a lot. You know, though palm oil costs 20 rupees lower than a sunflower, thus people have stayed away from palm oil and people have shifted in large numbers to sunflower, which is supposed to be a very healthy option. So we got away in April and May by not spending too much money on media at all. You know, otherwise our media spends are plus 2.53 crore per month in Tamil Nadu alone. So we got away by not spending any money in media in April and May. But we did do a lot of work in digital in the digital space. You know, in social we were very very strong and we did a lot of very tactical stuff with Rashi Khanna in Hyderabad, with Venkatesh Bhatt in Tamil Nadu. So we shifted our attention into social. We were very active on FB. We were very active on Twitter. So a lot of our attention went into social. And with social, what you could actually see is that you do a campaign, you are able to see the results immediately. And many of these campaigns cost 1/4 the monies that you try and splurge on a TV channel, right? And the benefits are right there for you to see immediately. We did a Venkatesh. I was telling somebody that we did a Venkatesh Bhatt Visvilayabad campaign a couple of days back, and by the end of the day, we had a 10 lakh plus viewership on our FB page. So that's the trend, right? So it's completely shifting towards digital, and I think with digital, the measurements are very up and clean up there for people to see, and sure, that's the way things are going to move forward.
Thanks. And coming to Mahesh, interestingly, India Cements has had a very good PAT, 17% or so last yesterday, day before results. So I forgot to discuss that with you yesterday, but does that say a message for paint industry in specific and in general? And of course, for Nippon, I mean, your mascot is more famous than the paint itself, I guess. It's all over the place. And your story on the paint industry and, of course, how the construction industry is faring, because I think they're interlinked, right? You could probably elucidate.
Yeah, thanks, everybody. Good morning, and good morning, all viewers here for this event, one of its kind. Thanks, Shankar, for putting it across, and thanks, Sriram, for moderating it also. Yeah, I also got the news about India Cements results, but I didn't want to comment on that. But how does it travel from cement to paint? Is paint is almost at the fake end of the construction industry, right? Generally it gets postponed, or generally it gets downgraded. By the time he comes to painting, he would have exceeded his budget. so they try to degrade or downgrade their specification, or they just say, okay, instead of that premium product, I might go for an economy. That's how it's. So what happens in cement, maybe it'll take about 4 or 5 months to come to pace. That's the transition. Cement and steel are the core segments, and if they do well, maybe we can see paints doing well in another 4 or 5 months' time. That's the transition. I mean, that's the travel time it happens, actually. And also, I would like to split both. What happens in the cement and the steel sector is the new construction, where more dependent on the new painting. And 30% is only new painting and the paint industry, decorative paint industry, if I have talked about. 30%, 30-35% is new painting, and balance 17% is the repainting, the replacement market. The uniqueness is generally a new painting happens through a migrant labor. The construction company has migrant labor and he only does the painting. Whereas the repainting happens through a native painter, And generally, even if any of you, if I ask a question to you, you will say, yeah, I do painting through my painter who has been doing right by my father days, or he has been doing for the past 15 years with me. So you always go back to the painter and he only does the painting. Generally, that's the whole, the whole industry works upon. So here comes the very, very important question, like, are you confident enough to let your painter inside your home? You know, you always have the doubt that whether anybody comes inside the home will have any infection or any positive, he should not spread the disease. So that is something which every paint company is working upon. So so just to talk about paint industry, it will take a little bit of time for us to come back to the normalcy. It is not like your essential commodities, like oil or FMCG product. You can term it as a semi fast moving. It is not even construction. I would not say it's pre construction industry also. So that's the part of the paint industry. So it will take a little bit of time for us to come back to the normalcy. Coming back to the mascot, I think we are blessed enough to have a mascot like Blobby, which is very popular amongst even the kids. We were very surprised to see that, a category like paint, a kid is loving to use a Blobby for her birthday, or a kid's Blobby cakes and everything coming out. That's a blessing for us. In fact, touching base on advertisement part of it, when we decided to do a campaign in Tamil Nadu way back in 17, so we wanted to take one state at a time rather than going full hog across the country, because we will not have the muscle power to fight against the competitor or the market leader across India. So we said take one state at a time. So thankfully, we took Tamil Nadu, my favorite, or the homegrown brand of mine. We have a factory here. So when we were contemplating whether to sign a brand ambassador like a Dhoni, that time we are already signed up with our CSK. So we were actually partnering CSK in their commercials. So we were contemplating between Dhoni and the superstars of Tamil Nadu like Rajinikanth or Kamala Hassan or this, that and all. But the research said, we went to the research and we found out that Blobby was more powerful, more engaging than any of the superstars. So we said, let us stick on with the Blobby, and it was a grand success. In fact, for your information, Blobby originated in Malaysia. About almost, I would say about 8 years back, 2012. In fact, Malaysia, our Nippon Paint Malaysia will invent that Blobby. Blobby is a drop of paint, a drop of paint. It's a blob of paint, and it gets that shape and size and it travels. So it's very interesting, very, very interesting that Blobby is unisex, actually, in the sense, so you can't say it's a female or a male. That's why if you next time with a Blobby, you'll find a and logo exactly at that place to hide it, actually, whether it was a male or a female. so it's a common for everybody. So Blobby is something very which rewrites our history in paints. So people associated with that. So that's how it has been for our journey in Tamil Nadu so far. We actually changed it a bit. We had a technological edge to Blobby. So Blobby started traveling on a hovercraft and things like that when it came to us to reinvent Blobby. So that's the reinvention we have done in Blobby in Tamil Nadu. Yeah.
Very interesting to hear that Blobby story. And of course, Nippon, Vishy, you're the one which brings all the, you're like the palm, all the fingers of the five fingers are brought in together by the palm, which is the media planning and distribution agency. So we spoke briefly yesterday, Vishy. You were saying that, news as a genre has picked up, in a very big way. You say, darling are the advertisers now, the rates have gone up. What has been your overall industry trend in terms of how brands have been investing money on advertising? Is there been an uptick? And of course, we also spoke about the films, the movie channel. So your thoughts on the overall subject.
Thanks for the opportunity. So the point which we were trying to make is, clients, to be very honest, have been taking a very slow start starting April. And clients have been in a very watch and wait and watch mode in April. I'm just talking about clients starting from an app client to a laptop client to an FMCG client to a client who sells gas. We have clients who we have a client called Shell who are into gas stations. They were hugely affected. Gas stations hardly advertise in India. You can hardly find people advertising. Shell does advertise in gas stations. So April was an extremely cautious month, and I think people slowly realized that, you know, May 15th onwards is when everything, people kind of realized that, you know, this is here to stay and life will go on and things will change, and slowly people started moving. From a client's perspective, I think they figured it out. Most of the clients figured it out what's happening in media because they were experiencing it themselves, to be very honest with them. They figured out that, you know, it's TV what they are watching, their friends are watching TV, the ratings were saying it was TV and it was news channels, we were all very anxious and watching news channels. So an anecdotal thing which came right in a big way, because, you know, of course data obviously proved it, but people were actually experiencing it. They were on their mobile and now they're watching TV. So there was no outdoor because we were all indoor, cinema halls were closed, and radio stations were hardly doing anything. So the point is, so what happened is it was only the bank who kept ratifying it, saying that, you know, whatever intuitively everybody felt what they were doing was actually happening across a larger population of people. So what happened was that, you know, I don't want to repeat it, but clients obviously, so for most clients in India, for most clients, whether you're national or regional, after HSM, Tamil Nadu is the biggest market. If you take HSM as market, then the next big market is Tamil Nadu, whether you take a Colgate or largely whichever brands I have worked out in my life, Tamil Nadu becomes a very big market and they have a factory in Tamil Nadu. So that becomes another big thing. So they have that's therefore what happens is, therefore, most of our clients, two things happened in this whole thing. Clients who are not on digital took the leap of faith on digital. I mean, a lot of clients who are skeptical, who are not, like, I'm really talking about our clients who knew that they had to take the faith on digital, in a big, maybe regional clients or clients who are in a, maybe a global experience from a digital perspective, because they don't have other colleagues in other countries to come and tell them stories and they have to take their own. They took the leap of faith and that started benefiting. And obviously, that has added a lot of color to the way media mix is, and channels have figured out what they have to do, and everybody seems to be going the digital way. So that's one big thing which has happened, and that's habitually become a good thing and hopefully become a continue to happen. TV, I think most of you all have mentioned what's happening, but TV is here to stay, and I think TV is here to stay. And print, unfortunately, I think there was a lot of miscommunication that the paper is not reaching houses in Bombay. I think it's a rather sad story, because it's like, you know, it's all come back actually, but, you know, this whole thing of, you know, I didn't get the paper today, my aunt didn't get the paper today, or we have stopped watching paper and reading the paper. So print, I think, is slowly limping back. I think the biggest sufferer in this whole thing is, I think, print as a medium. There were a lot of RWAs which were not leaving people inside initially, saying that, you know, the paper will have some issue and all those things. So I think it should come back, because I personally feel that, you know, that there is life in the medium still. I mean, it's not dead and gone. So that's where we are. TV and digital, and good for clients who have not taken leap of faith on digital. So that's where, and most of the clients have come back. So they know that, you know, they're back on air and they will be to almost the critical level. I think if you look at, I mean, from an AdX perspective, I think it was like down by some 20-25% in the first 2 months or even more than that. But I think it's almost, and I'm almost maybe in the next couple of months, but we are there. The clients are figured it out that we have to live with this. So that part we are fine.
So, Vishy, I'm going to hold on, you know, to you now, take one more round and come back to you. A lot of questions to you on specific categories on how brands have been advertising and who has not been advertising. But coming back to Srikanth and taking, you know, the thread right from there on the print. Yes, I think Vishy was very right. You know, there's a lot of myths around, you know, the newspaper transmitting the coronavirus of all things. We continue to buy chips and snacks and biscuits and vegetables, but we believe that the virus will not come from there. And of course, the logic was that you can wash almost all of those, but not the newspaper. So I think that is where, you know, the human psyche has been set. But Srikanth, you were releasing quarter page ads in newspapers, you know, and every time I would see that, I would be, wow, this is amazing. And true to the essence, it was O to O, which is offline to online. you were telling readers through newspapers to go to your website and shop Gold Winner. And you also took the opportunity to communicate new categories such as olive oil. I mean, please share your thoughts and experiences on, literally embracing the print media to move people from offline to online.
Corona has taught a lot of things. In fact, my company chairman, who's 74 years old, keeps telling us that Corona has taught our business a lot of lessons. And one of them has been the biggest issue of the shops being closed and people not having accessibility to buy edible oil. Right. So as an organization, for us, if we are not able to be there, for the consumer, when the consumer wants it and when there is a huge, increase in terms of home consumption, if you are not able to give the product to him, then there is a problem. Right. So actually, Corona forced us to go online. And we tied up with Swiggy, we tied up with Zomato, we tied up with Dunzo, we did all that. Now, unfortunately, many of the consumers actually do not know that Swiggy has a grocery platform, or a Zom has a grocery platform, or Dunzo has a grocery platform. Very few people know about it, and very few people take advantage of that. And fortunately, and that was the time when we also had a website. Now, when you go to a Zom or when you do a shopping on Swiggy, the costs also spiral up because there is a delivery cost that is involved, right? And as an organization, the company always has believed that the product has to be sold at a price everybody buys it. It should be a mass product, it is affordable for everybody. So the next big option for us was that why don't we make our website into a fully e-com platform, convert it into a fully e-com platform, and actually start servicing consumers whoever wants it directly in their homes. And that's how the whole genesis evolved. And that's how we converted our website into a full-fledged e-com platform. And
e-commerce.
You'll be amazed to hear this. Out of, let us say we get 100 orders a day, about 75 to 80 orders are consumers who are ladies. Ladies place these orders. And out of the 100 orders, 65 to 70 of them are already prepaid by consumers. The consumers, even though we have a pay on delivery option and there are no extra costs, if you pay cash on delivery, right? Still, people prefer to take the digital route. And for us, that's a big revelation. So, and every time we do an ad, we are able to see spikes. Immediately, as soon as we do an ad that day, when we did an olive oil ad that day, we got about 150 to 200 orders in Chennai. Right, and those orders sustained. The orders continued. If I did a campaign on Sunday, the orders continued to pour in on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So media that way has been, print media that way has been very friendly, and we were able to negotiate pretty decent rates with TOI, and TOI was very, very open to come forward and work with us. In fact, we are taking this whole piece forward and want to do a lot of stuff over the next weekend also with Raksha Bandhan coming on August 3rd. So
nice.
That's a good experience.
Nice. And since we spoke about offline to online, more people spending time on digital, Bhavna, yesterday we were talking about, Carvaan, which is one of the coveted pieces available probably for sale. And to the benefit of others, I was telling Bhavna yesterday that in the last 3 weeks, I've traveled to at least a dozen or so electronic stores, the Chromas and the Reliance Digitals and so on. And the Tamil version of the Mini Carvaan, the Bluetooth-enabled radio cum speaker, which features the Tamil songs and those of MS Subbulakshmi, have all been sold out in the city of Chennai, at least wherever I have visited. And this goes to show that the genre of music is so popular and strong here. But that's not what I'm going to quiz you about, Bhavna. There was something disruptive that the brand did. And heading Copcom, I'm sure there was a lot of thought that went into it from your side in terms of reaching out to consumers and, the wow moment. So I'm going to let you break the surprise and share with all of us the learnings and the anecdote of that particular exercise which Carvaan did.
Okay. So, what we realized during this lockdown that there is a huge movement back to the old familiar. So Doordarshan coming up with Ramayan and breaking records. So you realize that people are looking at getting back. And I think this was also the time people connected with their families far more, because you hardly got to spend time with them. And music somehow is a very big kind of an integrator within families as well. And the best thing about Karwa is that you just put it on and you forget about it. You don't need to keep changing songs. You don't need to think about a playlist. And that's the main USP of the product as well. So during the lockdown, there were a couple of initiatives which we took as a brand. And again, to make sure that you also kind of somewhere come out as being there close to the consumer. So one was the whole foray into the old age home. So we reached out to people saying that they could talk to, they could give us the name of any old age home around them and we will send it. And it was very nice to see the kind of joy it brought to those people. And especially, again, they're so cut off from everybody right now. It was, and then you see people dancing to the music or, you know, just swaying to it. It's just a very good thing. The other initiative which we've taken is also we realize that a lot of the people who are there in our the delivery boys and all who come, they have been losing out on the source of income. So we came up with something called the Karwa Sathi. So which is that the person, like your electrician, plumber, anybody could become a Karwa seller. So they end up coming to houses and they can talk about the Karwa, and if they are able to convert the sales, the entire retailer dealer margin actually goes to them. So for them also it becomes a good source of revenue, and we've seen quite a bit of traction on that as well.
Fantastic. And coming back to Shubha on the topic that we discussed yesterday and also today morning, Shubha, on how hygiene as a category has evolved during this pandemic and how more dollars are being spent across media. It all started off with one particular brand saying that, you know, use whichever brand of soap you want, but please wash your hands. And then, you know, one led to the other, led to the other, led to the other. And then, interestingly, back home in Chennai, Kavin Care, you know, they launched the 1 rupee sachet, you know, a disinfectant. There's been a lot of disruption, I would say, as a category, right? And traditionally, although in India, we've been taught to wash hands before every meal or before we pop in something, I think somewhere the whole concept of washing hands has been diluted. But now, thanks to Corona, you know, the whole thing has come back. But your take on how this category of hygiene, you know, soaps and disinfectants and hitherto unknown categories such as your the sanitizer, you know, how has the media evolved for that? I mean, are we seeing only the offline part, or are we also seeing a lot of it going online?
Like I said, you know, Sriram, there is nothing in life that teaches you better than a great deal of adversity in life. That's true of humankind, right? And if you actually look at the entire Corona pandemic, unfortunately, it has obviously created a lot of, you know, pain for humankind. But this is also a time where it has taught each and every person across the world to take health seriously, to take hygiene very seriously, because we know that one small step that, you know, we miss in our hygiene routine can cause, you know, it can be something between life and death kind of a situation for us, right? That's a very big lesson. That's the biggest theme and takeout from this entire pandemic. Having said that, this also has opened up in the last 4-5 months, a whole deluge of multiple products categories in this entire personal care, health, hygiene categories. It has also taught us, a lot of us, I mean, my most favorite example is this whole analogy on, you know, vaccines used to take 20 years to develop. And if the top scientists in the world can crush the timelines for a vaccine development and push it to a trial stage to less than 1 year, which is just, you know, unheard of, phenomenal. And if I take the same analogy back down to all our businesses that all of us here are present, There is a lot of other industries who are not present here, probably who are listening, engaging with us. Everyone has been forced to sort of relook at their models. People have shown tremendous agility across the board, across industries. They've reinvented how they've been designing their processes in-house. You know, for example, let's take the whole product development cycle and bringing it to market. That entire time span has shortened like crazy. Of course, we are not scientists, we are business people. And all the more reason that whether you are a lay person, whether you are a business person, whether you are a marketer, whether you are a scientist, or whether you are a milkman, everyone across the world has reinvented themselves. Look at our own lives, right, Sriram? We've all actually revamped, we've adapted to a lifestyle which we never probably thought of in Jan. We never imagined, but here we are living it. Correct? Now, closer home at GCPL, we've basically launched around 12 products under the Protect brand name, multiple categories. We have face masks, we have vegetable cleansing agents, we have hand washes, and we have a multiple array of products. And nothing less than a miracle, nothing less than, you know, sort of crashing all kind of norms and timelines and schedules. But the biggest learning and takeout for me is that, you know, if you really want to do it, you will overcome every adversity and do it. And the key to all of this is a combined sense of purpose and huge amount of collaboration. And that's been a fantastic experience, you know, this whole learning curve of how, when something becomes very important, how you prioritize that, put all your focus and energies there, and we've been able to churn out some fantastic products, and we are there actually. You know, the consumer is most important for us. Their needs right now lie in this whole segment where they expect a lot of solutions, whether it is washing your vegetables or washing your hands, or you want a great quality mask. So we have a Protect mask. We have a part sanitizer we always used to have, Sriram. But the other multiple products that I'm talking about, these 12 products, they're all completely new. And that's something that I'm obviously super proud of. And a great lesson learned, you know. So I'm saying today, I mean, we are actually living through these months where there is so much of innovation all around us, across professions, across categories. And I think that is a whole lot of learning that each of us can pick up at a personal level, and we can take a lot of inspiration.
Interesting. I think two big takeaways from you, Shubha. One is the time taken to develop a vaccine, you know, which is probably 1/10 or maybe 1/20 of the time. And of course, the second one is how, you know, we have adapted to current times. You know, we spoke about agility in the morning, you know, how corporations, big, small, large, XL, double XL, triple XL. I think we've all said that, hey, we have to work within the constraints. We don't even have a choice. Mahesh, to you, you know, we both advertise on the same radio station. And of course, I hear the other radio stations as well, where we don't advertise, to see what are the other companies and brands which are advertising. And I particularly remembered and very honestly liked that call in to one of your distributors, you know, wherein it's an advertisement, but it's actually a call in to a distributor asking what's happening in the industry. And his, and I'm sure that's a real distributor, right? It's not like a made up advertisement, but I think the whole thing sounded so real. You know, it was like somebody calling and checking how are things, and you know, that particular. So communication as a medium, and specifically I wanted you to touch on the radio part of it, you know, where radio has been, like how Bhavna mentioned, I think it's been a trusted companion to many of us during the corona times, because there is no fresh GC content, you know, films are getting repeated. Like today morning I was telling my classmate that I can start a movie on Monday afternoon, carry it on Wednesday or Thursday in the evening show, and in the weekend I can see a night show of the same film, you know, cut into two or three pieces, because they're just coming in on a round robin rotation basis. So your thoughts on the radio as a medium, Mahesh, you know, your success stories, and probably tier two, tier three, were you able to get more traction, more brand salience there?
Yeah, actually, we were on radio on and off, in fact, during our brand investment campaign. During this lockdown, we use radio to a very great extent because radio can reach out wherever mobile can reach. That's it. That's as simple as that. Your TV medium cannot reach to a place because you need a cameraman to travel, and you know it's all been there. And now, of course, there are some mobiles which can drive. You know, we as a reporter can carry that mobile, and then we can shoot and edit and do it. Radio, particularly, it was a medium where we have to reach out to the informal sector, the painter sector. Radio is the only medium we have. Of course, print, and generally the print medium is also a medium which reaches out to the informal sector, which is painters, and our distributors who are in the tier 2 and tier 3 mediums, where the tier 3 markets where they listen to radio a lot when they are on the shop itself. You know, every shop, everywhere you go, there'll be a constant music which will be playing. So that's when we thought about this radio medium to reach out to them and use that for communicating to the consumers also, that you know, we are a brand which is very, very social conscious, very hygiene conscious. So post lockdown, the first lockdown itself, we did restart our business. We started our plant with complete sanitization, and our depots were completely sanitized. We went to the dealers, I mean, our critical dealers, important dealers. We also gave them free sanitation, sanitization for their shop. And we used very, very reputed agencies to do that. And from my depot, from my warehouses, we have about 40 warehouses. After the sanitization, all the paint cans and pails had a sticker called, sticked onto that, sanitize for your safety. You know, so that the consumers come and buy with a lot of confidence. So confidence building has been our main focus for whether on the painter side or on the consumer side. To build that confidence, we wanted to use it. So the message was communicated through the distributors to the dealers. He's a retailer, actually, though. The one which you listened was actual retailer. Maybe you would have listened to a dealer who's sitting in Tuticorin or sitting in the remote place of Nagarkovil talking over the radio, and people listening to them, that come to my shop, everything is perfect, everything is sanitized, and it is safe to buy paints. And also the well-being of them, you know, we maintain social distancing. I communicate with my dealers. I meet them on a virtual call, and I tell them, please, you know, stick to all the norms. What has been, we made an SOP for the dealers, guidelines, what to do post lockdown. You know, you have to maintain social distancing. That will build up an equity for you. You know, short term, it might not be looking good. People might not come to your shop, but over a period of time, that is what is needed. So a lot of dealers in the tier 2 and tier 3 towns are practicing it, actually. And they make their staff to wear masks and stay at the social distancing level. And they also make the consumers to stay at the social distancing level. All these messages, we were communicating to the customers through the radio channel. So radio has been very, very useful for us in Tamil Nadu as well as in Karnataka also. Karnataka, in fact, as I was telling you yesterday, we got the more buck than what we paid for. So we want, they were coming out with a lot of ideas how to, you know, communicate to the customers, and they were really, we have some very, very unique products which are, we have a product called for air purifying paint, which applied on your walls, it keeps on purifying the air, right? And it absorbs the formaldehyde content in your air, and it gives you a very quality oxygen to breathe. So they did a lot of small snippets, and you know, that communicated to the radio channels. So we it was very useful for us. I mean, that's the message which I would like to communicate here. The real benefit of radio we came to understand during this lockdown, and even today morning I just attended one online radio event wherein in Karnataka we launched a product. Virtually, we launched a product through Facebook, and the product launch happened at the radio station. And we had a celebrity coming in there. My dealers were there maintaining social distancing. That's what Subha was telling, like, you know, we don't stop. Mankind don't stop. When it pushes to the wall, you find ways to live with it. You have to live with it. There is no other way. And It just got over. I mean, it's still going on. I just came and joined this event. It started at 10 o'clock.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming over. That's the way we have evolved. I mean, not only me, not only my company, everybody has evolved to live up to this expectation. That is what we want, actually. So that, you know, we are safe. Since the normal comes in, you know, we are ready with to rebound and rebounds back. Yeah, so radio, definitely, yes, it has given us a lot of avenues to stay in touch with my stakeholders and consumers. Remain on top of the mind, always, yeah.
Fantastic, Mahesh. Vishy, I want to ask you something. I mean, I don't want to build a controversy around it, but honestly, I think, and I think Bhavna will also accept, you know, there has been a north-south divide in terms of how, you know, communication is perceived and delivered, and, you know, how the media perceives South India and, you know, probably North India or Western North India is probably different. And very interestingly, you know, I try to glance or probably go in depth at least 4 to 5 newspapers every day in the morning. I don't read physical papers anymore. I read it digitally on the Maxtra app. And I found something very interesting today, and I thought I should share with, you know, this August gathering here, and also quiz Vishy on this especially. So Vishy, today is the 116th birth anniversary of the late Sri G.R.D. Tata, right? There is a quarter page solace in the Times of India and Hindustan Times, but not on the Hindu. Is South India separated or is it different from a media planning point of view? Do brands nationally, regionally look at this market differently? It's very, very surprising, right? I mean, I was talking to a few other panelists here on how the media houses, you know, how they perceive South Indian brands. So very interesting anecdote by Bhavna yesterday and by Shubha this morning. You know, we had two different extreme ends of how brands, media treat brands and media looks at South and North companies. But specific to Tamil Nadu, Vishy, what's been your learning? I mean, is there a divide North South?
So from a consumer and from a client perspective, I think probably the small people in town are. Among the few smartest people in town are based in Tamil Nadu, both from a client perspective and a consumer perspective, because in my personal experience, I want to comment on the Hindu ad today, but Hindus, you know, the whole of the rest of India can be, if you go back to maybe 20 years ago, when in 95-96, when Sunday launched or anything, within about 3-4 years, they had rural penetration and urban penetration and all the
game. Vishy, sorry, we're not able to hear you. By the time Vishy joins in.
Just, I had one question to Bhavna, since I'm a movie buff. Bhavna, are you aware that in the movie, Tamil movie called Petai, Rajinikanth used to carry this caravan? Was it a marketing gimmick from your side, or he used to carry that whole movie? You know, I don't know whether people have watched it, but I am a Rajinikanth fan. So he used to listen all old songs of Tamil. Was it a real thing, or was it happened by the director? I don't know.
So this happened before I joined the company, but as a marketer, I would say that most probably it would have been planted. So, I mean, that is a pure marketer, I can say that.
In fact, I really thought about, you know, presenting one to my mom, who's 80 years old and she's alone at Trichy. She listens to all the old favorites of Tamil, you know. So I asked, like what Sriram was telling, I went in search of some old songs, not very old, maybe 60s, 70s, but I didn't find one. Maybe I will search online. Yeah.
Sorry, cutting back. Vishy, are you there? Can you hear us? Yeah. A little bit. Yeah. So you're talking about the North-South divide.
Yeah. So basically, I think my take is that, you know, some of the smartest people from a client and, you know, live in this part of the world, not that they don't live in other parts of the world. But the point is that, you know, they understand the consumer pulses faster and they keep changing, because the consumer in Tamil Nadu is more experimentative. He keeps experimenting many things as and when he wants to jump into something very faster. So I think you have to, I agree with what Srikanth said, you know, what they got into their print and then digital. So I don't, so it's like, you know, it's one country by itself, you can say, because It's called people watch only Tamil. 99% of the people watch Tamil content. Maybe the rest of HSM watches Hindi content, and Bombay people watch all kind of content. But in Tamil Nadu, maybe people watch only Tamil content. So there's nothing that we do differently, but only thing is that the market is so critical for every advertiser or every marketer that, you know, they need to be on their toes to keep changing, and they have a huge local competition here, both from a media perspective and the national brands have huge it really doesn't matter. You're a huge national brand in Tamil Nadu, you need to fight the local guys in a very, very big way, and Tamil Nadu is one market like that, you know. So when we handle brands which are local, some of them are very stronger and much better than the larger national brands in those markets. So, I mean, I just want to make one point in this from my client experience. I mean, so there are categories today which have re-emerged. So since I work in a very diverse portfolio, let me tell you one category which had only about 10% penetration in this country, and you'll be surprised. For the last 10 years, the category is PC as a category. This category, after the lockdown and people started working from home and children started to study from home, has suddenly grown up as a category. And most of these people who manufacture these PCs also have all the factories in Tamil Nadu. Whether it is a Lenovo, HP, whether it's a Dell, all of them are based in Tamil Nadu. Lenovo is based in Pondicherry, but it's not really very far away. But, you know, so what I'm trying to tell you is this whole thing of the state being a country continent kind of a thing, you know. I'm not saying it's, because I think people are also like that. They also feel that they are different and they are cut apart. I mean, every state feels like that, but definitely. I don't think there is rocket science from a media planning perspective, but I think from a consumer perspective, yes, definitely, they keep evolving.
Coming back to Shubha, where we had, you know, you're trying to patch in for Vishy. Yes. Specific to Tamil, Shubha, on Tata Sky at least, the first channel begins at 1603 and then it goes up to 1698 and 99. 1699 is the Doordarshan Tamil. 99 channel bandwidth, you know, for one particular language, right? How do you think, we're all coping every day. There is a challenge, 55, 60 odd channels to showcase our products and services on. And then there is this top, you know, top five, top 10 mafia, if I could say, and then mafia in a sense, in a positive sense, because it's the typical Pareto, right? I mean, we all of us know what we're talking, but, you know, we can't talk about it, but yeah, that's okay. It's an 80-20 Pareto, right? You know, 80% of the visibility audience comes from 20% of these channels. So, you know, I'll start with, you know, Shubha, and then, of course, Srikanth and Mahesh, please join in.
So, I'll go back to my team, Sriram, that adversity is also a great leveler, right? So definitely adversity
absolutely
has required flexibility in the media, it's also in terms of business. To ensure that all our businesses flourish and all our businesses grow, whether you're a broadcaster, media owner, or you're an advertiser, or you're an agency, end of the day, all of us have a certain level of cohesiveness and interdependency on each other. That's a very, very important aspect. That's so central. Now, if I were to look back at the last 3 months, initially there was a lot of resistance, but the fact is that, you know, you're also as a broadcaster selling something which is old content, correct? So I have to say that most of the broadcasters, most of the media owners have been pretty cognizant and aware about that aspect. And yes, there has been a massive reduction in the overall advertising dollars for businesses like ours. I think a lot of other advertisers also, there has been a reduction. Having said that, I also understand and I identify the fact that everyone has business pressure, and at some point in time, this should all, you know, come back to a regular level of revenue for everyone. There is also a great deal of, you know, difference in the way media is consumed, right? Across, like you rightly pointed out, this whole example of 99 channels. Now, clutter is very much today a reality that all of us have learned to live with. Whether it is radio, whether it is another area which, you know, which is really booming. If you even take podcasts have been mushrooming like crazy, right? And if you actually look at the diversity of subjects and topics and languages and offerings on podcasts, it's crazy. Sometimes I feel that you literally now are moving into an era where you have to do individual media plans, right? It's that as crazy as that. Now, in this kind of a scenario where clutter is just going past all established norms and there is a very specialized content which is available, one has to be very cognizant of the effectiveness, efficiency, and ROI perspective at all times. So I would say that I would have expected, to an extent, I'm a little disappointed when I look back at what has happened in the last 3 months, because as an industry, when we work together, we need to be very, very aware that, you know, in times like these, we need to have, and we do expect, and we also are ready to give in that level of flexibility and collaboration. Somewhere I feel that has been a little lacking, Sriram. I don't think I really sound too controversial saying this, but when you are in this business for a very long run, and when you deal with advertisers who also been around for a very long time, I would have expected during this kind of a time a little more flexibility, a little more approachability. But glad to say that we are seeing movement in that direction. People are, at least in the month of July, I've seen people have been far more flexible than they were in the month of March and April. So that's
right.
Where it is.
Right. One suggestion to Shankar and the organizers, perhaps in the next such seminar, it might also make sense to bring in a broadcaster as a panelist, because then we get to hear the other side of the story as well, right? Just to have a balanced view of sorts. Srikanth, your views, you know, have you flexed muscles with the broadcasters? Have you been spending the same amounts in a lesser period of time than before? Have they been friendly and nicer to you to reduce the costs, both Mahesh and Srikanth? But we'll start with Srikanth.
It has not been easy, frankly, Sriram. It has been a little bit of arm twisting that we had to frankly do. As Shubha was saying, it is not that, people have not come proactively forward and said that, hey, mate, here, these are the rates now. Come on, let's now, you know, come back and start advertising, you know, the way we used to do earlier. That was not really the case. In fact, we had to go and talk to them and tell them that, boss, your TRPs are fallen. You're no more having any new content coming up. You're just rehashing the whole stuff. Come on, you cannot charge us the same amount of rates that you were doing earlier. So we had to do a lot of arm twisting, whether it was a TV or whether it was print, you know. So, but having said that, when we started, putting our, weight behind the whole thing, and when we started telling them that, boss, this is the way we want it to be, I think people then had no other choice. And also because the number of advertisers were far and few. You look at the Times of India today, there are hardly one or two people who actually advertise. Yeah, TV is slightly better off, but print media is quite bad, you know, at this point of time. So we had to actually do a little bit of arm twisting, and finally we were able to get our way off. But having said that, Tamil Nadu has been more amenable, I would say, to this, to this requirement of, bringing down the pricing compared to what we go through in Karnataka or in AP. AP and Tel, people continue to be on their high horses, and we continue to have a slightly a tougher time there, making people understand that, boss, times have changed. You can no more charge the premiums that we are doing earlier, right? So that is the situation as of now, Sriram.
Thanks, Srikanth. Mahesh, closing thoughts, and then I'll quickly move on to Vishi for something interesting as well.
Sriram, maybe I may not be able to tell exactly the way it has been behaving like, because my marketing team scale takes care of that completely. I only give them the premise to work upon. Definitely, we had a haircut, slight haircut actually, but we just wanted to be on the top of the mind of consumers. As you know, paint is not a category where you see today and go and buy tomorrow. No, that's not that. You have to be constantly on the top of the mind. So we have to be there at present at a way very accommodatively, or I would say optimistically priced and things like that. So definitely I will not be able to pay the money what I paid for a repeat content, right? Definitely not. So we were actually on a social, you know, public awareness campaigns and things like that on the news channels and things like that. But what I would say, like, you know, the Tamil channels or the Tamil the products available are very good, really. And of course, the reachability is also to that extent. So they have the, you know, consumers on their hand. I mean, they have the power to dictate with us. And we have personally experienced that as a brand also. One particular brand which are associated with suddenly went to a competitor the next year itself. So I mean, you can't. They're not basically doing social service also either. No, it's for them to. They work within the premise. They came to us for a first mover advantage or things, and then went on to the competitor also. So it's for me, it's like a, you know, make hay while sunshine. Whenever they want to make the most of it, they do. And during this type of times, as what Srikanth was selling, more amenable also, not to that extent what Subha was selling, because she's been thick and thin of things. So she would have expected a bit more, but not happened actually. But I would be neutral in this actually. So very amenable. I mean, I don't see that to be very, very high-headedness. But the content what they give is completely different. I mean, I can easily relate to a product called Big Boss. I mean, I can reach that. I know Big Boss took Nippon to the nook and corner of Tamil Nadu. I mean, that's the fact. That's a reality. So I could sense it, like, you know, that's people didn't want to associate with that channel. I mean, with that product actually, or the not the channel, the format of that content itself. But when they did, people, whether knowingly or unknowingly, watched that program across Tamil Nadu. Whether they liked it or not, they wanted to really hear what is happening inside that home, right? So sure. that way it has helped us a lot, in fact, I would say. So they are having that muscle power. In fact, unless and until the viewership completely takes a turn, and like what in Kerala, like, you know, it's not overly heavily dependent on only that TV media. You know, you have audience across. You have right. to work or you have to play the field wherever you are working, whether in Kerala or Tamil Nadu or places.
Bhavna, last part, probably we'll take your thoughts on that, and then we'll move on to Shankar. He's got a huge list of questions and answers as well. And before I go to Vishy, one thing to you, Bhavna, was you know, on the you know, as a platform, you know, Twitter, Facebook, you know, there has been so much of churn that is happening there, and that's also media, by the way, because somebody is consuming something or the other there. And then you have this genre of news, you know, where there's so much of corporate push that is happening during the corona period, you know, be it CSR, be it about the promoters or the directors, or there is on one side, there's a huge negativity of willful defaulters and all that. That's a story which is brewing since probably November, December last year. And then all of a sudden, this whole thing, the corona happened. I think all of us have forgotten all the bad deeds by the corporate of India. And then we have, you know, only bad news coming more and more through corona. So do you think, I mean, outside of RPSG group, do you think news as a genre and, you know, the digital part, you know, the Black Lives Matter, that had a huge impact on Facebook, the revenues crashed majorly. So do you think new genres of spending money, are they brewing for small brands or even regional mid-sized brands?
Right. So it is. So just one thing here first, Sriram, that even though a lot of large advertisers have dropped out of the Facebook platform globally, it has not really impacted their revenue so much. It's about 6-7% of their overall revenues, because a large part of their revenues come from the retailers and the smaller advertisers. So, you know, so they are affected, but not to the level which maybe a TV channel could have been affected if maybe a Unilever kind of pulled out. So that's just an aside. But, you know, now what we've seen is that given the whole way people are now being at home, and I think this is going to stay for at least a few more months now, gaming as a platform has now largely come up. So across various target audiences. It's not only men, but even women. It's not only the younger age group, it is also the older age group. So there is one huge chunk of people who are getting into the gaming thing, and especially, you know, in the initial time of the lockdown where people were not even able to order groceries and all from the online apps, this was something which was keeping them busy. So that's one genre which is coming in heavily. The other bit, again, when radio, we've already spoken about, especially, you know, when people were sitting at home, I mean, not actually sitting, everybody was doing the household chores and you needed something in the background. You couldn't be sitting and watching TV all the time. So that was something, music. So music is coming up across genres, across various, across various kinds of music. So it's now a lot of original content which is happening. There are a lot of original UGC which is happening. So yes, TikTok has been banned, but there are other apps which are proliferating. So again, there's a lot of time which people have, and this is really their revenues, because again, TV was not giving them too much of new content. So movies as a genre did see a rise. News as a genre saw a rise. That's what we've spoken about. But outside of TV, there are a lot of seismic changes which are happening in the whole media landscape. So of course, TV is here to stay. It's not that TV is going anywhere, and given the kind of largesse which is there in India. But there are a lot of new things which are coming in, and there are a lot of ways that advertisers can spend money and actually get better ROIs, or more measurable ROIs, I would say, than what maybe a TV or print is providing to us right now.
Fantastic. So I think to all of us here, there are more and more new opportunities which are coming up. So it's not just the TV or probably the mainstream, print and radio. I think there are a lot of other options. Last question to you, Vishi. In terms of the rebound, we're seeing constantly automobile companies, small, medium, large, different, variants and segments, what we call as the ABCD segments. All of them are advertising. Especially both on television as well as on print media. The same with the two-wheelers as well. You spoke about personal electronics. I think there is a huge surge in terms of demand. And most importantly, on the real estate front, there were days on Sundays where there were more real estate advertisements than probably editorial content or news on national newspapers. Today, we don't see that, right? Where have all these guys gone? Isn't the real estate market crashing? Shouldn't they be probably advertising now on print? Do you see, therefore, a spin for advertisers like us, small advertisers, large advertisers? Is there a benefit right now that you foresee coming in from the print media?
Coming to benefit, I think the print media guys have already given the benefit to consumers. They actually, for maybe the Times of India and Hindu, they might have come in late, but I think they've already started. They've given a lot of benefits to the clients. I mean, maybe not the forum to discuss that, but they know that it is a survival issue for them. And as far as the real estate advertising is concerned, is most of the real estate guys have this equity deal going with most of the Times of India and the Sun Times of the world. So that's how they have this deals going with them. So presently, with no sale of home happening, like absolutely no sale of home happening, even rents are not happening. If you come to Bangalore, I live in Bangalore. If you go 1 kilometer, you will see at least 10 or 2 kilometers, you'll see at least 10 to let boards in Bangalore for houses and real commercial estate. So, people moved away from the city. So, real estate is something which is going to take a while to, unless they bring costs down. Even I understand Bombay is a big city and it's a bigger city than Bangalore and all that. But I, being in Bangalore all my life, I really don't know why people pay premium in Bangalore to live in the city. Many people even blame it on the weather. Okay, it's a great weather. I mean, I refuse to understand these things. Okay. So my point is, it's a fact of life, when people end up paying. So real estate guys have to come to reality and to live in Bangalore. So I think that they can take them back. Other ones are amenable, you know, they come through your way you want, and they're pretty amenable. So that's been my experience.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I think
fantastic. So I'm going to take.
Sorry. Yeah, Shankar, you can take.
Go ahead.
So the point which people have just had made a point on, our costs come down, or what is the thing on costs? One thing which I mean, all clients, apart from the costs they get, even if they work with an agency or they work directly or however they work. One very critical thing to the cost they pay for every single thing is the kind of people who work on the business. Okay, finally, you know what happens is from the agency side, or if they do it from their own side, because the point is, you know, in this business, it's still one-to-one relationship. You can have a great relationship with certain people, you can manage a lot of things and get away. Get a lot of things out of you for that organization on behalf of your organization, and that is a very personal thing which still happens in the industry. So if you work in an agency, it's very critical that the kind of people who work, if you do directly, it's very important that the kind of people who have, the kind of way they treat, it's very, basically it comes to human things. It's nothing to do with your work and your knowledge and how you treat people. How you manage people, when you don't give them a campaign, how you still come manage to hold that person in the right side. Those things actually add up to a lot of savings. They nip away, come a lot of value to the clients who they work for, which is a very, and it's a people industry, you know, which one point I just wanted to make. That's it.
Thanks, Vishy. We are running short of time, so I'm going to end our interaction here. And Bhavna, just to tell you, I was reading last week that there are 700 films awaiting release in theaters. 700. Wow. You know, India produces about 2,000 films annually. Half of them are in the Hindi language, and immediately followed by Tamil language, which is about roughly 350 odd films. That's roughly 4 to 5, sometimes 7 movies per week. And then just followed by that is Telugu, which is the two states of Andhra and Telangana. But all together, there are 700 movies waiting for release. And we're really, really hoping that both the state and the central governments are going to give us some good news tomorrow, you know, about the Unlock 3.0 plan starting Saturday or perhaps Monday. So, Shubha, do you think cinema advertising, you know, the big screen advertising, implanting stuff there, you know, do you think there is a void which has been created because of that? And therefore, how is that void being overcome? Through possibly, you know, digital media, especially where cinema consumption is happening.
So, Shriram, just to understand this a little more clearly, you are saying the degrowth of cinema advertising as a void, is that what you are mentioning because of the current
lockdown? That's correct. That's one of the audience queries, okay. Questions which has come. Yes.
Okay. So, I mean, if you actually look at all around us, this whole heightened sense of, you know, awareness about how to keep yourself safe in open spaces, in common spaces. If you actually look at even the WHO directive, as you know, recent as yesterday, I happened to hear it on television. The higher risk prevails is in closed indoor spaces where a lot of people gather, and which are especially air-conditioned spaces, you know, because that is where your whole transmission is supposed to be most, you know, potentially highest. Now, cinemas are enclosed spaces. So I definitely see that part actually as something which is going to take a lot of time in terms of getting back to normalcy, because I also happen to see this whole, you know, capsule on television where PVR guys were actually showing how they were sanitizing, you know, after every show, and how there is going to be one person, one seat vacant between two people. But, you know, somewhere with this level of fear that actually has happened to all of us is a little difficult. You know, your priority is actually right now, even if unlock happens, for all of us. And I think we can all, it will resonate very well with everyone, you know. The first priority is actually to get out of the house and live life normally in terms of even commuting. I mean, look at all of us. We're all sitting inside. I have not stepped out except for very important essential items, and all of us are working from home, or we've adapted, we've learned to do everything from home. In this kind of a scenario, getting back to watching movies, I mean, whether you have 700 or whatever number of movies, today you have all these movies being live streamed on Amazon Prime and on Netflix, right? I mean, that's changed. To me, this seems to be at a pace which is going to be much slower. So even for us as brands and advertisers, we'll have to reinvent on how we are going to use that communication and messaging. So if I was earlier targeting people watching cinemas in cinemas and creating some experiential kind of collaboration for my brand, I'll have to rethink. There is no other option right now. At least in the next few months, I see that as a consequence. But maybe, yes, probably after November, things may sort of pick up.
Change, you think so? Hope so?
Yeah, I'm hoping, I mean, at least for all of us, for everyone's sake, because it's a matter of livelihoods, you know, Sriram. I mean, at the end of it, we may think of this as business and brands, but at the end of it, you know, the number of livelihoods impacted negatively because everything around is shut. Definitely for the sake of that and for the sake of economy, everything has to improve and change. So let's hope, fingers crossed.
And last question, taking a thread from the same entertainment, I'm gonna charge it upon Vishy, but of course anyone else, you know, if you have thoughts on that, then can definitely feel free to answer. Vishy, have you been getting queries from your clients to push their communication and advertisements on OTT platforms? Have you seen a swing there? I mean, Shubha just mentioned about Amazon Prime, Netflix, and so many other. There are a dozen OTT platforms, by the way, and we don't have enough space to keep most of them on our mobile phones or other devices. You know, the most colloquial ones are, of course, the Prime and the Netflix. But Vishy, are you seeing clients saying, I want to advertise on this OTT platform because there is an Amitabh Bachchan movie which is being you know, telecast there? So are you getting that? Are you getting that query?
Honestly, not to that extent. I'll be very honest. The different clients are at different stages in on digital and OTT and everything digital in that ecosystem. So they have not come down to that level of, at least my clients have not come down to that level of asking, because one or two might have, but they have not come down to that because they have only taken a leap of faith. Many of them have taken a huge leap of faith on the medium and trying to move in that direction. But there is also this lingering thing of the general human psychology of clients is like, you know, who is watching it? Where is it going? Instead of giving the data and information. So I just gave you an example yesterday. So Facebook allows you, they give you pin code wise targeting, right? They give you pin code level targeting, Facebook. So there are clients.
Yeah,
we discussed that yesterday. Clients who are trying to do it in a level of pin code wise tracking, try to figure out whether it's actually coming in wherever it is coming in. Evolving. So, the long answer short, I don't think we've reached there. Yeah, but it's not very far away, but it's in different people are at different stages, I think.
Yeah, Sriram, I'd just like to add here that we have actually started spending more on the OTT platform for our communication in the current times, because again, we see that there is a large traction and the rates are coming down. So just to also take a benefit of the rates and kind of do your test and learn as well. So we are moving, I would say not a sizable chunk, but at least more than what we used to do earlier on the digital platform. But yes, having said that, it is still going to the maybe a YouTube or a Hotstar, because again, Amazon Prime and Netflix haven't opened their platforms to advertising. So that's something which we are doing for our brands.
Fantastic. I mean, if you let me, I'm going to continue this post lunch as well, but I don't think we can. We're all short of time and we've already gone past the schedule. My sincere apologies to everyone who has been delayed because of our constant interaction and bit of a jabbering here, if I could say colloquially. But Shankar, over to you. I think we would allow you to take over the show. Otherwise, we'll all keep talking more and more and more because this is something that we all live every day to do. So over to you, Shankar.
No, thank you. Thank you, each one of you all, for having made it. And I'm so sorry we had to start late for whatever the teething problems we had. And excellent session, Shrikant, Bhavna, Mahesh, Shubha, Vishi, and Shriram. You guys killed it, if I could say. You know, I've actually I've been flooded with response, and I don't want to again bore each one of you with the kind of questions, but just a couple of observations. Shriram asked a very pertinent question on clutter in broadcasting, clutter in media and entertainment. You know, pre-COVID and post-COVID, there was somebody who came and told me that the number of sanitizers, pre-COVID were, let's say, about 3-4 brands. You know, today there are about 300 brands. So, one point is, there is clutter everywhere. Broadcasting, while, I should talk for broadcasters, media and entertainment now, otherwise I'll be banished, the kind of response what I've been getting. And the second point is, Shrikant was mentioning that, talking about rates and, channels having repeat content and all that. See, what I would like to, share my submission is, broadcasters are equally affected. What happens is, when there is nothing has actually, our costs have not come down even by 1%. So I wouldn't like to make it controversial by bringing in various other regulators and bodies, but what I would like to say, our costs have not come down by 1%, and our team continues to report. I'm saying, whether it is Pudhiya Thalaimurai or V6 or whatever, we are there on field. The guy wears a mask, he wears those gloves and all that. There are tremendous pressures what we have, and despite that, we've offered our best of deals to Shrikant. Especially, and see, I can take the liberty with Shrikant because he's my classmate. He'll not pounce on me. We've known for more than 25 years now. So the point is, as Vishi rightly said, there is are we bringing down our rates, bringing down everything. Yeah, in a good situation, it could work. But yes, there is pressure everywhere. And anyway, though, so I will not take much time. And it's been great. And then there is another chapter of Tamil Nadu, which we are doing on 21st of August. And because TN is such a big state. And what I liked about this e-conclave is, when we started, Shriram started off saying the South has 5 states. It's taken so much of time, trust me, believe me, to tell my clients, my advertisers, my cohorts, they say, no, 4 states. Either they get confused with AP and Telangana, or they miss out Telangana. I tell them, no. So when I was talking to somebody, I wouldn't name the film celebrity came back and said that there are no 5, there are 6. Why have you excluded Pondicherry, Puducherry? So get confused with these names. But I'm so glad and so delighted that Shriram, you time and again you started saying that South has 5 states. With that, thank you all.
These are 6 months away, so you can probably expect the 6th state to be born very soon, and that's more a mandate from the people more than anything else. So once it happens, then I think, but trust me, from a media point of view, all the 6 states, okay, maybe Telangana and Andhra together speak the same language, but all the other markets, they're completely different. The consumer is very, very different.
I agree.
Tamil Nadu, Chennai works differently, ROTN works differently, Bangalore works differently, 50% cosmopolitan, 50% Hindi-speaking belt, and the balance 50% are probably Kannadigas and all the other languages, while ROK, as we call, is hardcore Kannada, And then, we at Levista Coffee, we are actually planning to release our ad in Tulu language for the Mangalore belt starting next week, because we felt that there is a sizable Tulu population. They all watch Kannada programs, but all of a sudden, when they see or hear a Tulu ad, which mentions Levista, then I think it's going to sit on their memory for a long time. So I think we're a fantastic country, and there is so much of diversity, and that's what brings us all together. But Fantastic meeting each one of you
Thank
here.
You. And it's been an eye opener for a lot of people, including me and Shubha, Srikant, Vishi, Bhavna, Mahesh, Shiram. I can't thank you all enough. And I look forward. I'll keep troubling you all, and there'll be more and more sessions on evangelizing South India. So please come and be a part of it.
Most welcome.
Thank you so much.
Bye bye. Stay safe. Yeah, thank you.
Bye. Thank you. Bye. Bye.